Griffith, and thank you to my colleague Angela Burns for bringing forward this important topic. Cabinet Secretary, the deal between NHS Wales and Roche is terrific news for breast cancer sufferers in Wales and a perfect example of what we can achieve when we work in conjunction with the pharmaceutical industry. This deal and the new treatments fund means that women with HER2 positive tumours can gain a few valuable extra months of life and avoid the issue we had with Herceptin. These new innovative treatments are targeted at relatively small cohorts and are much more expensive. What is the Welsh Government doing to ensure we are aware of drugs in the pipeline? And will you work with your colleagues in England, Scotland and Northern Ireland to achieve commercial access deals on other initiative treatments in future?
Yes, I'm happy to respond. Of course, this particular drug has an average 6 months of extra life, and it's about the value and the cost of that. And again, these are really difficult assessments to make, which is why, frankly, politicians are often the worst people to try and make that assessment. However, on the broader point about the understanding of what is in the pipeline, I actually had, in recent months, a very sensible conversation with the Association of the British Pharmaceutical Industry and their Wales Rep board member, who happens to work for Roche, and which is a matter of coincidence, but about the manner in which we have conversations as drugs are being developed and at what point in time the pharmaceutical industry can have that conversation with governments and with appraisal bodies. Because the sooner you know something is potentially available, the earlier you are able to plan. And actually, that sort of grown-up approach is really important for us, because the NHS has to be able to try and budget for new treatments coming on board. It has to be able to try and plan the infrastructure around those as well. It's often more important than the cost of paying for the medication cost. And it's then also about the industry understanding that it has an interest in being open at a slightly earlier stage with us about what is coming down the line. Otherwise, we're not having these sort of fights on a basis that isn't good for them as an industry partner, isn't good for the health system, but ultimately isn't good for the individual citizens who are then caught up in a campaign between different parts of the public sector and the industry who are trying to offer a treatment that they are saying will provide a real benefit for them. So I'm optimistic that we are continuing to have that grown-up and necessary conversation about the way in which we work together and understand our competing interests. I don't try to sell the pharmaceutical industry they should not be entitled to make a profit in the way they run their business and what they put into developing new treatments. But it has to come at a price that is affordable for the taxpayer and with real value in terms of improving outcomes to the individual citizen as well.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. Next, the 90 seconds.